So while we wait for our couple of more sellers to join in, we are on schedule. We'll be starting sharp at 3. I would like to quickly walk you through the tools that we are using today so that even you can enjoy and have a good experience in today's webinar. Just for your information, we are using GoToWebinar tool today, and there are a couple of things which is good to know information that you should know. So at any point of time, if there is any question or anything that you want us to go ahead and notify, you can definitely go ahead and type in your comments on the comment section. That is the questions tab. You can start asking questions right away so that we can look at it. And when we are open for a question and answer session, we pick up your questions. Also, please note that today our expert would be Shubhrat, who would help us in understanding the payment section better. That would help us in our in preparing for the upcoming festive season. Also, during the webinar, we will be enabling a couple of polls requesting your response as soon as possible. So before we begin, I would like you to go ahead and answer to one of the poll. Whenever such polls will be there on your screen, you will not be able to view the presentation window that you were able to view. So the moment we close the poll from our end, you will be able to view the presentation. By default, you will be placed on mute. Please note that. We will be able to unmute you once we move to the Q&A session. Based on our experts' availability, people will be unmuted. However, our first priority would be given to the questions that you have asked. So you all can start asking questions. I can see a couple of meaningful questions coming in. However, we are requesting all the sellers to kindly stick to the topic. Do not ask any other questions as we might not be in a position to go ahead and provide you a 100% accurate answer. So requesting your patience, and we would go ahead and start immediately. So I'll be your trainer and host for the day, and my name is Manisha. At any point of time, if you have any queries, you can directly draft in your comment on the questions tab. So while we look at it. Now let's proceed further and understand. Today we will be learning about the payments dashboard. We got a lot of questions when it comes to the transaction and when it comes to the, you know, the settlement after the return, the cancellation, the revised GST. We will be going ahead and covering all those topics and understand the payment section better. That would help you in order to understand what you are actually gaining. So first we will be starting with payment dashboard. So please let me know if I am audible now. So when we speak about the topics that we will be discussing today, so we will be starting our today's webinar with payments dashboard. One at a time, we will understand each and every segment that is included in payment dashboard, and then we will be moving on to the settlement when it comes to the return or cancellation. So let's proceed further. So when we talk about payment dashboard, this is how it looks like. So let me quickly go ahead and open the dashboard for you all so that you all can go ahead and we stay in the same page. So in order to go ahead and check the payment dashboards over here, you can see this is the payment dashboard that we will be referring to. And this are the segregation. So we have payment overview where we will be able to go ahead and take a look at the entire payment section. Then we have got previous payments, that is the payment that happened last time. After that, you have got transactions. Transactions will help you in understanding the entire settlement. Then you have got invoices that you can go ahead and generate and download and keep it handy. And finally, you have got the statements. It's just like bank statements. So let's start with payment overview. When you click on payment overview, this is what you will be able to go ahead and see. This is the entire payment overview page. This page will help you understand what is the next payment. That is, if it's postpaid, how much is it? If it's prepaid, that is already paid by the customer, how much is it? What was the last payment? That is, in the last payment cycle, what was the payment that you have received in the bifurcation? The total outstanding payment that you are to receive from Flipkart for all the dispatched orders. So it includes everything. However, your next payment will give you an estimated value that you will be able to go ahead and get. This might change as per the returns that might come in before the next payment cycle. Then you have got unbilled orders. Unbilled orders over here, you'll be able to go ahead and download the upcoming orders that would help you in calculating the next payment that you'll be receiving. When we speak about report section, you'll be able to go ahead and download the FY report, that is the financial current financial year report. Also, you can go ahead and look the net withholding and local deduction certificates that will help you in calculating your TDS. Accordingly, you can go ahead and check the business report and also commission invoice. So let's go ahead and start by clicking at certain parameters to understand what exactly it is. Also, if you want to know more about payments, you can always go ahead and check the three FAQs which is provided over here. In case if you have any payment related question, you can always go ahead and learn about the payment policy and you can get your certification today. So if you click on this, so you'll be able to understand how the entire payment settlement thing continues, and that will help you in gaining more knowledge with regards to payment. Similarly, if you want to know when will you receive the payment, you can always click on this and accordingly see. As it's mentioned, it's as per the tiering cycle. If you are a gold seller, within next 7 days, you will be able to go ahead and get the payment. For silver, it's 10 days, and for bronze, it's 15 days. So this is how it would look like. Similarly, you'll be able to go ahead and understand each and every journey, how it will be effective. For example, if it's a courier return, that is RTO, obviously there would not be any changes. If it's customer return, in this case, how will it look like? And if it's customer return replacement, how will the entire reversal look like? So now, this is how you'll be able to go ahead and learn things. In order to understand better, for example, for the next upcoming payment cycle, if you want to learn more about, you know, the postpaid, what are the orders that has been included in postpaid, and also about prepaid, you can just click on the amount and you can see the description would be provided, the amount would be provided. You can learn about the entire cycle. So each segment comprises of order transaction that is related to your orders. Then you have got storage and recall transaction that is specifically for Flipkart fulfillment, where if you recall an item or if you go ahead and use the storage facility, how much would be the price that is involved? You also have your non-order SPF transaction. You have got your TDS transaction and you have got your ads transaction. Ads transaction are the campaign-wise level view of the amount that has been incurred in terms of using credits for advertising your products. Now over here, similarly for last payment also, you'll be able to view the same details. When it comes to total outstanding, is the same view that you'll be able to understand. If you're not able to follow anything directly, you can always use this double-headed arrow. You can click on this and that will help you in understanding details in a better manner. For example, if this is the order item, this is the status. Over here, you can go ahead and see the amount that the settlement amount that you will be getting. In case if you want to learn more, you can always click on learn more in order to learn more about the details. So as this is a test account, you might not be able to see a pop-up window. However, you will have a pop-up window where you can search for a particular item and then look for it. Similarly, you can click on View Transaction History to understand what is the scenario. Over here, as you have forward, that means for the item that has been forwarded to the customer, and when it's returned, you will have return written. In case if there's any particular file like this over here, any particular column which says adjustment, that would show the adjustment that Flipkart has done while settling your amount. So this is how you'll be able to go ahead and understand and accordingly take decisions for each and every individual order that you go ahead and see. Similarly, for Flipkart fulfillment, storage and recall transaction, you can open this and understand that how it worked. You can always go ahead and search your item by order value, the order by your order number, the order item, or the item ID, the recall ID. So we'll learn more about this in some time. Also, you can always go ahead and download the file that you need to and keep it handy in order to understand things better. So now moving down, you can always go ahead and see, as mentioned earlier, that you will have unbilled orders. These are the orders which are yet to be dispatched. And once dispatched, payment will be scheduled and they will reflect in total outstanding payment section. So you'll be able to go ahead and have an aggregate, you know, on an average, how much amount you will be getting for your next payment cycle. You can do the calculation over here. Similarly, when we talk about the report section over here, first is FY report. So let me try downloading one for you and show you accordingly. Kindly bear with me while we are trying to open this. So here you can see the reference number would be given, the type of order, the fulfillment type, then the seller SKU, then the order item, order ID, the dispatch date, all those information. You will have a raw file in order to go ahead and do the calculation. So you can see accordingly, all the amount has been provided over here. So you can keep this file handy, as that would help you in understanding how did your financial year go. Accordingly, in business reports, it will help you in tracking the sales for your tax computation and your reconciling payment. So if you click on this, it will take you to the report center. You can go ahead and click on new report and accordingly download the report that you need to. For example, if you need tax report, you can download the tax report and take actions accordingly for the range that you want. You can also go ahead and directly go to the report center. It will directly take you to this particular page where you can go ahead and download the report. So you can see what are the reports that you can download and what exactly it is. All those information are mentioned over here also if you click on types of reports. Now, these are a few of the things that payment overview will help you in understanding about your last payment, about your upcoming payment, that is your settled and unsettled value. The next one when we talk about is previous payment. Previous payment would help you in just having an idea. You can also refer to the NEFT ID or the settlement date. This will help you in understanding how were your months going on and how much payment you were getting. So that would help you in going ahead and planning your business accordingly for the upcoming. It is always better to know that what went wrong and how could it have been done better. If you, for example, if you look at August data, that would help you in understanding the money. You can always go ahead and click on payment overview and download the report if you want, and accordingly plan your next month, specifically looking at this festive season. That would help you in preparing in a better manner with an agenda that you need to earn this much. Finally, we come to the transaction page. In transaction page, let's look at it. So when we go ahead and talk about the transaction page, you'll be able to go ahead and view your settlement details for all the types of services. For example, if it's orders, you know, storage, if you have recalled an item, the TDS claim, the ads. So in an enhanced way that will make things easier for you to understand. For order payments, we provide complete payment status, settled and unsettled amount based on the order date and order ID or item ID. For example, you can use order date search, so over here, to view payment status and history of all the order items dispatched for the sale events like the Big Billion Day. So those are very important for you to keep an eye on, because that would help you in going ahead and keeping an estimate of all the orders that you were able to go ahead and settle successfully, and what's the amount that has already been settled and what's the unsettled amount. Apart from that, you can also view settlement details for the storage, recall, ads, and TDS transaction by selecting a date range or entering the listing ID, recall ID, campaign ID, or the claim ID. So in this page, you can see you can either enter the range or you can go ahead and enter an ID. And similarly, once you have entered the range, you can go ahead and download the file to keep it handy. Now, in the transaction page, when we look for it, the first thing that you might have noticed is this particular arrow. So this summary shown on this page are aggregated number. For example, for an order ID, this page shows the past, that is settled amount, and also the unsettled amount. And if you want to go ahead and load more transaction for that particular order, you can always click on that this particular double arrow and accordingly find needful. And also, as explained earlier, the double-headed arrow will help you in understanding more information about this. Please note, the net settlement against the item might be different due to returns or adjustments. So this thing you need to keep an eye on. So let me quickly see if I can go ahead and get some information. So over here you can see, similarly, you will have all information. If I click on this double arrow, I'll be able to go ahead and understand what exactly it is, and accordingly click on view transaction to see the transaction over here. So like I said, if you click on the double arrow, this is the page that you'll be able to see. And if you click on view transaction history, this is the page. So over here, it's forward column, which shows that the settlement is for forward orders. If there's return, you will have a return column. And if there's an adjustment that has been done, made by Flipkart, you'll be able to go ahead and see adjustment written over here. Please note over here, please keep an eye on this transaction, because that will help you to understand the settlement properly. And also for future reference, you will be able to go ahead and use the same thing accordingly. When we speak about invoices, so let's go ahead and see. When you click on invoices over here, it will directly help you in generating the invoice, the commission invoice for a particular range, date range, and accordingly you can do the needful. Once it is downloaded, you'll be able to go ahead and find your file over here and click on download to download the zip file. Let's take a look at it. Kindly bear with me while I'm trying to open this. So you can see this is the invoice, commission invoice. So I have downloaded it. So it is always important to keep all these things handy, specifically as you are a businessman, that would help you in keeping things with you on a monthly basis. And finally, we have come to the page where we will be talking about statements. So this statement, you'll be able to go ahead and download the settlement value for a particular period of time. Let me go ahead and see if I can show you. As this is a test account, it will be different. However, let me just go ahead and see. So this will help you in having the statement available. So let me just see if I get it somehow and I'll be able to show you. Okay, unfortunately, I'm not able to go ahead and see this. However, this will actually give you a brief graphical representation or illustration of how the settlement would look like. It's more like the previous payment page. It has been segregated. You'll have a breakup of each and everything that you need to know. Also, you can download the file, plus you can click on Know More to understand the things in a better way. So this will actually help you in understanding the prepaid and the postpaid for a particular range and how much were the details. So this statement file, as you can see, there has been a note that has been added that we have removed opening, accumulated and closing balance details from statement view. This page is under revamp and we will start showing back these details once we have validated all the balance. Statements are available only for duration after 15th of April 2015. So I would request you to kindly go ahead and download the statement for a particular date range and keep it handy. Accordingly, you can go ahead and download the statement for as per your prepaid or postpaid, as this will help you in keeping things easy. Maybe keep it on your desktop. That will help you in understanding the settlement and accordingly do the required calculation that you require. So this is particularly about payments. Again, I'll do a quick revision. The first one is payments overview, where you will be able to go ahead and check the next payment, the last payment, the unbilled orders, the total outstanding payment. You can go ahead and check the reports section and go ahead and download the required reports as per your requirement. Previous payments would help you in understanding your last month's payment that were settled already and how does it look like. Transaction page will help you go ahead and look at your transaction from a granular level that will help you in understanding the settled and the unsettled amount or how did your product perform overall. Over here, you'll be able to start with order-wise transactions, storage or recall transaction, non-order SPF transaction, the TDS transaction, and finally, the advertising transaction. This will help you in taking necessary actions. Accordingly, you can go ahead and request download. You can check a particular range and download the file as per your requirement. Sellers, please let me know if my voice is audible because from my end, it shows. Please let me know. Type yes on the questions tab because from my end, I just checked and it looks like everything is fine. Please let me know. Perfect. Now let's proceed further and try to understand things in a very granular level and better. We'll be listening to a couple of more videos and audios to understand things better. So please type yes if you are able to go ahead and understand the payments tab so far that we have explained. Okay, now let's go back to our presentation and check different scenarios of payments. So I'll be playing a video. Please go ahead and listen to it carefully, because that would help you in understanding how do you reconcile your payment for seller cancellation. That is, what if you cancel the order, how would the payment look like? So let's look at it.
Hi, welcome to your flip. Flipkart seller learning session. When you sell on Flipkart, you receive payments. But sometimes, a buyer places an order, but the seller cancels it. Or the buyer cancels or refuses to accept it. Or the buyer returns the goods. In this video, you will know how buyer and seller cancellations affect your payments. Let's recall what payments you can expect when you fulfill an order. The buyer pays the total order item value. As you already know, this includes the value of the item and Flipkart's marketplace fees, including Flipkart's commission fee, collection fee, fixed fee, shipping fee, and the tax on the fees. Ideally, you should receive the total order item value less Flipkart's marketplace fees and tax. Bharat seller account will show these entries. Bharat received an order, but the buyer cancelled the order before Bharat could mark it RTD or ready to deliver. The buyer had paid the total order item value, so the full amount is refunded to him. The full marketplace fee is refunded to Bharat. The tax is automatically reversed, so Bharat does not get any payment, but he does not bear any cost either. The same applies if the order is an RTO, return to origin, courier return, because of a courier return or if the buyer refuses to accept it. There is no effect on Bharat seller account. What happens if the seller cancels an order? Cancellation before marking ready to dispatch or product not handed over to logistics partner post marking RTD even after multiple pickup attempts. Fees are charged to the seller's account in both these cases. Why? Because a buyer has some expectations from Flipkart when they place an order. A cancelled order damages Flipkart's reputation and the buyer's confidence. Your business and Flipkart's business both will be affected. Bharat has cancelled an order before it is marked RTD. The buyer had paid the total order item value. Of course, the full amount is refunded to him. Full commission and service tax will be charged for seller. Not only this, the particular product will be delisted for a week's time. Bharat seller account will show a reversal of the total order item value and a charge of cancellation fee plus taxes on it. If Bharat is unable to deliver the product to the logistics team for an order after marking it RTD, Flipkart cancels the order if the product is not given to the logistics in 3 attempts. Since the fault is from seller's end, Flipkart considers this as seller cancellation. However, seller cannot cancel this in the system. It is initiated by Flipkart. The buyer is very disappointed. Of course, Flipkart refunds the total order item value to the buyer. Bharat seller account is charged a cancellation fee and the tax on it. It is much higher than the charges for cancelling before RTD. Bharat seller account will show a reversal of the total order item value and a charge of higher cancellation fee plus taxes on it. When Bharat, our seller, marked the order as ready to deliver, the buyer was informed that he would get his order soon. When an order is cancelled at this stage, the buyer is really disappointed. It leads to complaints and dissatisfaction. As a seller, Bharat can make sure he never has to face these high cancellation charges and incur a bad reputation. He must update his stock file to avoid getting orders for products which are not in his inventory, so that items ordered are in stock and he can deliver in time. Now you know the effect of buyer and seller cancellations on your payments. There is no impact of buyer cancellations on your payments. However, Seller cancellations do have an impact. Avoid them as far as possible. Watch the next video to know how payments are made in case of buyer returns and replacements.
Now let's go ahead and check in terms of returns how payments are made.
Seller learning session. Sometimes buyers return the items that they buy on Flipkart. They could ask for an outright refund or a replacement. In this video, you will know what payments to expect in case of refunds or replacements. Returns are allowed based on the product category. The different returns are as follows. No returns. 10 days or 30 days. Examples of no returns will be consumable products like software, personal care items, etc. Let's recall what payments you can expect when you fulfill an order. When a buyer places an order, he pays the total order item value. As you already know, this includes the value of the item and Flipkart's marketplace fees, including Flipkart's commission fee, collection fee, fixed fee, shipping fee, and the service tax on the fees. Ideally, you should receive the total order item value less Flipkart's marketplace fees and service tax. Neha's seller account will show these entries. Now, Neha's buyer wants to return the item and get a refund. The buyer had paid the total order item value and the full amount is refunded to him. You will see a charge of this amount in your account for the refund. The commission fee and fixed fee will be reversed and credited back to your account, along with the service tax which was charged on it. The shipping fee and collection fee will not be reversed as Flipkart has already provided these services. A reverse shipping fee will be charged to your account for picking up the product and shipping it back to you with the service tax to that amount. So finally, Neha's seller account will show a debit for the reversal of total order item value, credits for refund of commission fee, fixed fee, and service tax on them, additional debit for reverse shipping fee. The shipping fee and collection fee are not reversed. What if the buyer wants to get a replacement? The first two steps of the transaction will be exactly as you have just seen. After that, Flipkart will deliver the replacement to the buyer and Neha will see payments and charges related to this replacement in her account. It's almost the same as getting a new order. So forward shipping will be charged twice. Original product and replacement product, and reverse shipping fee and applicable service tax, except that Neha will not be charged the collection fee this time. So finally, Neha's seller account will show a payment for total order item value, charges for commission fee, fixed fee, shipping fee, and service taxes. As you can see, returns do mean that the seller has to bear some cost. Reasonable returns are expected in online marketplaces, and Flipkart continuously takes steps to make sure that your interest and the buyer's interest are protected. Which charges are higher for a seller? Returns or seller cancellations? Yes, the charges you bear for returns are much lower, as returns is a sales enabler. Now you know the effect of returns and replacements on your payments. Watch the next video to know.
So sellers, in this video that we have learned, the same video is already available on Seller Learning Center, where I'll be showing it to you, that way you will be able to go ahead and view the necessary information. We have one last topic to go ahead and check before we start our Q&A or before we go ahead and do the revision. So let's quickly go ahead and look at the revised GST that happened during this upcoming council meeting. So I'll also go ahead and share this copy with you. I've shared the same with you. You can open this at the same time. We can read it together. So it's written over here that the 20th GST Council meeting was held on July 21st, 2018 in Delhi, focused on simplification of doing business and tax compliance for small taxpayer through quarterly return rating and rate cuts on raw materials and manufacturing inputs. So the key decision announced that may have an impact on you are as follows. Taxpayer may opt for multiple registration within a state, union, territory in respect of multiple places of business located in the same state or union territory. E-commerce operator needs to have compulsory GST registration only on the non-exempt good. The threshold for GST exemption increased to 20 lakh from 10 lakh for six states, which are Sikkim, Arunachal, Himachal, Uttarakhand, Assam, and Meghalaya. For the ones with provisional ID who couldn't complete the process of registration, the last date has been extended to August 31st, 2018, and the late fee has been waived for return filing. The meeting has brought good news to all the taxpayer. While some good news will be exempted completely from GST, others have received some major relaxation in terms of GST. So let's look at the list of the goods with the recent rate card changes. So you can see in terms of Rakhi, the new rate is zero. The GST earlier was this. Sanitary napkins, circulation and commemorative coins, raw material for broom, stone, marble, wood deities, sal leaves and its product, khali dhona, carpet compost. So these are the ones where GST will not be charged. Similarly, you have got a long list of items and the GST that will be charged accordingly. So you can go ahead and take a look at this. I've shared with you. Similarly, the list of goods exempt, fortified milk, it has been exempted. And accordingly, new rates has also been given over here. So I've shared this with you. You will be able to go ahead and look at it accordingly and take your actions. So now before we move on to our question and answer session, we have seen a couple of sellers have been requesting to go through the same thing in Hindi. So let me quickly go ahead and take you through the dashboard in Hindi. Then we will start with our Q&A. So जैसे कि हम सब ने ये already सीख लिया है English में that यहाँ पे आप लोग आके आपके आने वाले payment या आपके last payment जो last payment cycle पे आपको मिला है ये सब चीजें देखने के लिए. So ये हमारा seller dashboard है जहाँ पे payments tab के नीचे ये सारे sub tabs हैं जहाँ पे आप सबसे पहले जब आप पेमेंट ओवरव्यू पे क्लिक करते हैं तो आपको ओवरव्यू मिल जाएगा आपको अपने पेमेंट्स के बारे में इंफॉर्मेशन प्लस रिपोर्ट्स जो आपको डाउनलोड करने हैं उससे रिलेटेड इंफॉर्मेशन भी यहां पे मिल जाएगा अगर आप किसी भी पेमेंट सेक्शन पे क्लिक करते हैं तो आपको वो डिटेल डिस्क्रिप्शन मिल जाएगा कि क्या क्या चीजें इन्वॉल्वड है उस पर्टिकुलर पेमेंट पे अकॉर्डिंगली आप ये डाउनलोड भी करके रख सकते हैं जिसको आप फ्यूचर रेफरेंस के लिए रेफर कर सकते हैं जैसे कि मैंने दिखाया था ये चीज आप स्क्रॉल करके और ज्यादा इंफॉर्मेशन जान सकते हैं अपने प्रोडक्ट के बारे में अकॉर्डिंगली अपने प्रोडक्ट के बारे में और इंफॉर्मेशन यानी कि उसका ट्रांजैक्शन हिस्ट्री या और भी ज्यादा डिटेल्स जानने के लिए आप ये डबल हेडेड एरो पे क्लिक कर सकते हैं और आपके सामने ये इंफॉर्मेशन आ जाएगा जहां पे आपको अपना सेटलमेंट वैल्यू प्लस कितना वैल्यू डिडक्ट हुआ है वो सब कुछ इंफॉर्मेशन मिल जाएगा जब आप व्यू ट्रांजैक्शन हिस्ट्री में क्लिक करते हैं तो ऐसे आपको पता चल जाएगा कि ये प्रोडक्ट जब फॉरवर्ड हुआ था, यानी कि जब आपने कस्टमर को भेजा था कितना अमाउंट था, रिटर्न हुआ तो कितना अमाउंट हुआ, और कुछ केसेस में आपको फ्लिपकार्ट एडजस्टमेंट भी दिखेगा, जिसका मतलब ये है कि फ्लिपकार्ट ने कितने एडजस्टमेंट करे हैं। सो इसके अलावा आप जब नीचे स्क्रॉल करेंगे आपको स्टोरेज और रिकॉल का ट्रांजैक्शन भी मिल जाएगा, यानी कि जो फ्लिपकार्ट वेयर हाउस में, फ्लिपकार्ट फुलफिलमेंट के वेयर हाउस में रखने के लिए जो जो सामान आपने रखा है या सामान जो आपने रिकॉल करा है तो क्या है, कितना प्राइस है, यू विल बी एबल टू गो अहेड एंड अंडरस्टैंड इट accordingly. Non order SPF transaction, TDS transaction, जो भी claims करी है और जो advertising, Flipkart advertising में कितने transaction हुआ है उसके बारे में भी details मिल जाएगा. So यहाँ पे आप check कर सकते हैं, claim ID है accordingly. So ये सारी details आपको सारे overview, payment overview, जहाँ पे भी ये सारे amount mentioned होंगे, ये आपको ये सारी information मिल जाएगा. अनफॉर्चुनेटली मैं पूरा का पूरा सेशन हिंदी में नहीं बोल पाऊंगी, इट्स जस्ट द रिविजन जो मैं दे रही हूँ. रीजन बींग आज का पूरा वेबिनार इट्स बीन कम्युनिकेटेड दैट इट विल बी हेल्ड इन इंग्लिश, बिकॉज ऑफ विच आर मेजर लैंग्वेज विल बी इन इंग्लिश, बिकॉज ऑफ द रिक्वेस्ट कपल ऑफ थिंग्स वुड बी रिपीटेड इन हिंदी. सो जैसे कि हमने ऑलरेडी बात किया कि FY रिपोर्ट यानी कि जो फिनेंशियल रिपोर्ट है, यहाँ पे एक डेमो है, ये ऐसे दिखता है. दैट विल गिव यू एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ कितना ट्रांजैक्शन हुआ है, सेल का अमाउंट क्या है, एक ओवरव्यू लेवल आपको मिल जाएगा. प्लस ये फाइल आप अपने पास रखेंगे तो आपके लिए भी फ्यूचर रेफरेंस के लिए इजी होगा इन ऑर्डर टू प्लान योर नेक्स्ट फाइनेंशियल ईयर. कमीशन इनवॉइस, आप अपना इनवॉइस या बिजनेस रिपोर्ट से रिलेटेड सब कुछ यहाँ पे डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं. अकॉर्डिंगली आप रिपोर्ट सेक्शन में जाके यहाँ से भी चीजें डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि आपको फुलफिलमेंट का रिपोर्ट डाउनलोड करना है या कोई इनवॉइस डाउनलोड करना है, जो पेमेंट रिपोर्ट है वो डाउनलोड करना है, वो सारी इंफॉर्मेशन आपको यहाँ से मिल जाएगी. जैसे कि पेमेंट रिपोर्ट पे जाके अगर आप नेगेटिव सेटलमेंट देखना चाहते हैं या आप सेटल ट्रांजेक्शन देखना चाहते हैं, वो एक्सेल फॉर्मेट में आप डाउनलोड कर सकते हैं एक पर्टिकुलर पीरियड के लिए. फिर आता है ट्रांजैक्शन का पेज, जहाँ पे सेम लेवल का व्यू है एंड आप यहाँ पे चीजें डाउनलोड कर पाएंगे. फॉर एग्जांपल मैं छोटा सा आपको एग्जांपल दिखा दूँ, यहाँ पे आप सेम इंफॉर्मेशन और ग्रैनुलर लेवल पे आप चेक कर सकते हैं. अकॉर्डिंगली दिस विल हेल्प यू इन अंडरस्टैंडिंग कि ये सेटल्ड अमाउंट है या अनसेटल्ड अमाउंट है और क्या क्या चीजें हैं. और इन्फॉर्मेशन के लिए आप जो दो हेडेड डैश था यहाँ पे क्लिक करके व्यू ट्रांजैक्शन हिस्ट्री पे भी आप चेक कर सकते हैं कि क्या है एग्जैक्टली. जब इनवॉइसेस की बात आती है, इनवॉइसेस आपको हेल्प करेगा जिप फाइल डाउनलोड करने में, तो यहाँ पे आप चेक कर सकते हैं. ऐसे देखिएगा आपका कमीशन या टैक्स इनवॉइस, ये कितना चार्ज हुआ है, सब कुछ आपको मिल जाएगा एक इनवॉइस का कॉपी. दैट माइट हेल्प यू लेटर डाउन द लाइन टू फाइल योर टैक्स रिटर्न्स. सिमिलरली स्टेटमेंट्स में भी आप अपने स्टेटमेंट्स यानी कि जो सेटलमेंट है, एक रेंज, एक महीने की रेंज तक यू कैन गो हेड एंड डाउनलोड इट और आप ये साथ में रख सकते हैं. दैट विल हेल्प यू इन अंडरस्टैंड कि पूरा का पूरा महीना आपका कैसे गया. आप अपने सेटलमेंट व्यू कर सकते हैं अकॉर्डिंगली एंड टेक एक्शंस. आप अगर यहाँ पे व्यू सेटलमेंट पे भी क्लिक करते हैं या पूरा पेमेंट चीज जानने की कोशिश करते हैं, ये आपको हेल्प करेगा ये जानने में कि आपके आगे का महीना कैसे होने वाला है, एक आइडिया क्रिएट करने में. और जो महीना जा चुका है यानी कि जो लास्ट पेमेंट था, उस पेमेंट में क्या क्या सेक्शन थे, क्या क्या ऐड हुआ, सो ये सारे आपको डिटेल्ड वाइज मिल जाएगा. एंड वी वुड रिकमेंड यू कि आप ये कॉपी अपने पास रखें मंथली वाइज. दैट विल हेल्प यू इन ऑर्डर टू गो अहेड एंड check the information. So sellers, aur ek cheez hai, if you want to go ahead and learn more about payments, you can go to Seller Learning Center. Let me quickly show it to you. You can click on the three dots. You can go to Seller Learning Center. And over here, you will have payments and settlements. You can go ahead and go through the same thing. There's something called as basics of payment. where you will be able to go ahead and understand things better, just like a commission invoice. You will be able to go ahead and have an idea about the TDS calculation, ki kaise hota hai, kaise TDS reimbursement, how to claim it. And then you will be able to go ahead and navigate through the entire page in a better way. Similarly, the dashboard navigation will help you in understanding how will you be able to go ahead and check your payment details. And your different scenarios, the one that we just spoke about, that payment reconciliation when it comes to seller cancellation and returns, you'll be able to check it accordingly. So you have a lot of things over here, jo aap ek ek karke check kar sakte hai. That will help you in understanding things better and accordingly help you in clearing your doubts in a better way. Just a minute. So you can see over here, TDS, how to claim it, what is TDS, that will help you in understanding what is the use of the commission invoice, how it will help you for your TDS calculation. You'll be able to go ahead and understand things better in a better way. Next payment, last payment. Like I showed you that agar aapka next payment jo aane wala hai to see, go to payment, click on overview, and the first thing that you'll be able to see is the next payment. Accordingly, if you click on home also, over here you'll be able to see a small window where the next payment would be mentioned. So this is where you will be able to go ahead and view accordingly and see ki kaun se item ke liye kya payment hai. So for example, last month also, if you want to go ahead and see it, you can go to payments, you can click on previous payment, and you can see ke last month ka kitna hisab hai. Similarly, aap statement pe ja sakte hai, you can click on statement and download your last month statement accordingly. So this is something that will help you in understanding things better. So sellers, abhi hum 5 minute ka break lenge jab aap sabke sab questions dekhenge, and then we would start with our webinar Q&A session in 5 minutes. Usse pehle aapke sawal mujhe hame dikh raha hai. So Param, I guess your question has been answered, how to check your last month's payment. Let me know. Similarly, you'll be able to go ahead and track your last month's sale also as per the order IDs that you'll be able to go ahead and look at it. So Akbar Ali, give us some time. We will look at it and get back to you in some time once we start the Q&A. Om, let me know if your queries are clarified as we spoke about the customer returns and the courier returns. We spoke about it. So I'm going through all the questions. Give us 2 minutes time. Meanwhile, please start typing more questions so that we can start looking at it and answer it to you. So please let me know. And also we would go ahead and pull up a poll. Ek poll aa raha hai aapke samne. Please go ahead and respond to it. And in another 5 minutes, we would start the webinar. I'll be putting the mic on mute right now so that we can go through all your questions accordingly. Abhishek, aapko kuch bhi sawal poochna hai, we are well conversed in Hindi. Aap Hindi mein bhi pooch sakte hai. That's not an issue. So I hope, jitna ho paya, I have tried to explain it to you in Hindi. Please let me know, aur kuch information aapko Hindi mein janna hoga, will help you in understanding. So, Om Prakash, the payment is a slight different for EasyShip. For EasyShip, what happens is once the services are completed, then only the payment would show up, unlike any other normal orders where, you know, services are not required. So I guess that helps you for. Aram, if you can elaborate what exactly is the tax report, because there are so many types of tax report that we talk about, like GST, then
TDS.
ITR, then TDS. So let me know which particular tax report are you referring to. Abhishek Verma, aapka jo question hai, how to get monthly buyer return charges in a file. So in that case, aap ek range ke liye, you can download the transaction file. Wo download karne ke baad, uspe aap filter laga ke, you'll be able to go ahead and do the needful. As a particular file, it's not available, but however, filters are available, jo aap laga ke check kar sakte ho. So Zakir, can you help me understand what kind of penalty that you are referring to? As we already discussed about, you know, seller cancellation and the customer return are the two major penalties, and we discussed how it will be affecting you if the same comes into the picture. So let me know if there's any other penalty that you are talking about. Ankita, to answer to your question, that is where can you check the sale of the promotion that you have opted in. So you can always go to growth, my promotions, and then you'll be able to go ahead and see the level of units that you have sold along with the revenue that you have generated. You can click on it and download the file that is necessary. Unfortunately, in payment section, you will not be able to check it. However, if you go ahead and open the orders that were the listing ID or the orders that were into opted in that particular promotion, you will have something called as My Share. If you click on View Transaction History, that will give you an idea of your share that you need to go ahead and burn for the items that you have opted into My Promotion. Sanjam K, to answer your question कि आपको कैसे पता चलेगा हमारी पेमेंट कब आने वाली है, तो जैसे कि मैंने आप लोगों को ऑलरेडी दिखाया, मैं फिर से दिखा देती हूँ. पेमेंट ओवरव्यू में जाके आपको यहाँ पे डेट मिल जाएगा. सबसे पहला चीज है नेक्स्ट पेमेंट, और आपकी टियरिंग के हिसाब से है. अगर आप ब्रॉन्ज सेलर हो तो हर 15 दिन में पेमेंट होती है, सिल्वर को 10 और गोल्ड सेलर को 7 दिन में होती है. सो अकॉर्डिंगली उस हिसाब से पेमेंट होगा. आप अपने जो आने वाले पेमेंट है वो आप नेक्स्ट पेमेंट टैब में जाके चेक कर सकते हैं. एनी सॉफ्टवेयर कंपैरिजन, प्लीज लेट मी नो व्हाट एग्जैक्टली डू यू मीन अकबर अली, दैट वुड हेल्प यू. आर यू रिलेटिंग टू एनी सॉफ्टवेयर दैट वी कैन गो अहेड एंड यूज और एनीथिंग एज सच व्हेन यू स्पीक अबाउट द कंपैरिजन? I am with regards to your question, I'll just read it out for everyone. That is, on Flipkart, 90% orders are fake as they're cancelled or rejected by the customer. When the product is out for delivery, there is 7% order accepted by the customer, but these customers are doing illegal activities like keeping accessories and returning the products. Few are keeping the new products and returning the old products with ship new product. Package, Flipkart is not even checking the serial number of the product returned by the customer. Only 3% are genuine who are accepting orders fairly. This is our experience till now. Due to false return, we are in heavy loss. How to prevent this mishappening? So Om Prakash ji, just to let you know, I'm not sure if you are aware about this or not, but in order to go ahead and help sellers specifically in this particular scenario, we have something called as SPF claim. It's seller protection fund claim, where the day you have received the product, 14 days, within 14 days, you will have to go ahead and raise a claim by taking a photo of the product that you have received along with a copy of an invoice. You'll have to send everything to seller support team who would help you in order to reimburse a certain amount. And after they go ahead and do some investigation, please ensure that you do this the day you receive your product instead of delaying things for later. And also ensure that the picture that you'll be providing for your product should match the listing, the photo that you have provided while going ahead and listing your product. So please note, you can always go ahead and learn more about SPF claim by raising a request to our seller support team, who would help you in understanding things better. So Ankita, again in payments tab, as I told you, if you want to go ahead and check about the promotions, it's not going to be easy. However, you can always go to My Promotions tab and you can go ahead and download the file, or you can check, right, the revenue from the promotions, that how much revenue you have generated from the promotion by clicking on it. And accordingly, you can download the last 90 days data or select a date range that you would like to go ahead and look for the gross revenue, the revenue that you have generated while getting your listing into this particular promotion, and look for it accordingly. View transaction history, whenever, as I showed you the double-headed, just a minute. So whenever you go ahead and open any of the order ID, below you will have view transaction history. Over here, you'll have something called as my share. That would, and also you will have details over here also, where you will be able to have an idea that what was your share and how much you had to burn because of opting in your product. Abhishek, nahi ji, jaise ki maine aapko bataya tha, courier return, you are not being charged anything. So it is something that customers have done it. Pradeep, advertising ka webinar kal hai. If you want to learn more, you can join our webinar tomorrow. Zakir, whenever there are cases jahan pe customer has returned your product because of some issues with the size or anything as such, this is somewhere, you know, you as a seller will have to keep an eye. Most of the cases, as a customer, we can say that, you know, the size that we see while ordering the product and the size that we receive is either too large or too small, because of which such issues comes into the picture. So I would recommend you to go back, look into the sizes of the product that you have put in, and ensure that you put in all the information about your listing that you should in order to attract your customers. Om, please ensure that when you are going ahead and claiming an SPF, you need to provide valid amount of proof. In that case, that would help you there. Param, when you say listing hijacking, what exactly does it mean? Akbar Ali, if you want to go ahead and get a record, SPF claim payment record. So over here, when you go to the transaction page, below you'll be able to see something called as non-order SPF transaction, right? Here you'll be able to go ahead and get your SPF transaction information. Param, over here you'll be able to go ahead and see gross revenue, though it's not a Flipkart, sorry, it's not a payment item. However, you'll find the gross revenue section majorly in promotions. That would help you in understanding the revenue that needs to be divided by the units that has been sold in order to gather the average selling price. So you can look over here. It's the merchandise value shown specifically for the purpose of recording sales. So in short, it means that the Flipkart marketplace charges has not been deducted, and this is the revenue overall that you'll be able to see it. Someone has asked a question. Unfortunately, I'm not able to see the name. If there's any option to contact of the buyer by us, unfortunately, no, because of confidentiality and a lot of things that happens. Flipkart does not allow you to contact your customers directly. That it's only your product doing the talking for you. If someone got, I have a question. I don't have the name, unfortunately. It seems that we got return charged by Flipkart. Please go ahead and see the information that I have showed you. If you got the return charged, see if the product was returned to you or not. If not, if it's incorrectly charged, then please go ahead and raise a seller support ticket immediately. Hi, Sunil. I just saw your ping. I hope that answer has been provided to you. Mohammed Sadiq, I already showed you how to find the monthly details of sales. Whatever payment will be there, you'll be able to go ahead and do the needful by going to previous payment section and going ahead and looking in terms of the sales that has been done for your previous month. Chetan, to answer your question, as we belong to the customer service industry, so in this case, you will not be able to go ahead and disable the COD payment. In case if in near future, if you can, we will communicate the same to you. Sellers, I'm really sorry. I'll be not taking questions related to promotions and advertising because those are a total different topic. In case if you want to learn more about advertising, we have webinars tomorrow for advertising. And in case if you want to learn more about pricing and promotions, then we have a webinar next week that is related to growth. You can go ahead and join us there and talk more about promotions. Let me know if there's any other question. More questions. That is, I want to block listing hijackers. Please provide some information about that. Param, jab aap baat kar rahe listing hijackers, so are you talking about latch on, jahan pe aap main seller hai aur aapke products pe dusre sellers aake products latch on karte hain? Agar haan, to in that case, I would request you to immediately go ahead or seller support ko contact kijiye with something called as brand infringement, jis pe you will be able to go ahead and जो भी प्रोडक्ट आप अगर ब्रांड के ओनर हैं, यू कैन टेक एक्शंस अकॉर्डिंगली. Sellers, please do let me know if you're able to hear me properly or not. Looks like some sellers are not able to hear me properly. We're waiting for a couple of more questions and we'll wait for another 2-3 minutes. Agar koi question nahi aata, we'll be wrapping up the webinar. Requesting ki aap log jo webinars से रिलेटेड है, पेमेंट से रिलेटेड ही क्वेश्चन पूछे, ऑफ द टॉपिक ना पूछे. अभिषेक, सेशन हैज नॉट स्टॉप्ड. आई एम नॉट श्योर इफ यू आर नॉट एबल टू सी मी और नॉट. इट्स जस्ट दैट वी आर नॉट यूजिंग एनी स्क्रीन एज ऑफ नाउ. अभिषेक, कैन यू हियर मी? प्लीज टाइप येस अगर आप मुझे सुन पा रहे हो. अगर हाँ टाइप कर देंगे और आपका सवाल पूछ लेंगे, बिकॉज ऑल आई कैन सी इज आप वॉइस इज नॉट कमिंग. Okay, sellers, हमें और कोई सवाल नहीं दिख रहा है, so we will be wrapping up our webinar today over here. You all will be getting the recording after 1 hour, and in case if you have any issues, then you will be able to go ahead and get in touch with us by writing directly to that email address where you have received the mail from. All of you will be able to go ahead and get the recording after 1 hour. That is, by 5:30, you should have the recording of the entire webinar. Last two questions, that is, CA को invoice details कैसे provide करूँ? जैसे कि मैंने सर आपको बताया कि you can go to the payment section invoice and you can generate the invoice for a specific range जो आप download करके commission invoice जो होता है, जिसका मैंने आपको already एक copy दिखाया. So accordingly आप वो copy अपने CA को provide कर सकते हैं वहाँ पे जाके. Specifically, we will be ending the webinar now with the festival tip, because it's the festival season, so hum tips prefer karenge to let you all know that ensure that you keep an eye on the payment section tab. Jab bhi aap payment pe check kar lijiyega har ek return, specifically jo humne sikha hai ki seller cancellation and the customer returns are two important things that you should be keeping a tab on, specifically festival mein, jahan pe bahut sare log aapko order karenge. Jahan pe bhi possible ho, ensure aap apne inventory tab mein jaake apna out of stock product refill karte rahe rather than it staying out of stock or low stock. Accordingly aapko yahan pe ye bhi pata chal jayega ki kaun sa stock kitne din tak chalne wala hai. Accordingly you can go ahead and refill it. If there's any concern, payments related koi bhi issue hai, it is always better to go ahead and do the check. You can download your, you know, previous payment and accordingly go ahead and match your current payment and last month's payment so that you can check out the difference and take correct decision for the upcoming month. Those are a few of the things that you can do in order to understand things better. If you don't know things about GST or anything as such, please refer to the Seller Learning Center. वहाँ पे सब कुछ है related to payment, कैसे calculate करना है, settlement कितना है, rate card कितना है, commission कितना है, everything is there. Please ensure कि आप सब लोग वो follow करें and always keep the statements handy, monthly statement download करके. It will help you in comparing your credits and debits accordingly. So that's pretty much all. Thank you so much for joining today's webinar. In case agar aap logo ko aur bhi questions hai, you can always write directly to us and let us know things. So tomorrow we'll be coming back with our Flipkart advertising. Seller Learning Center, please keep a tap of it. You can always go to Seller Learning Center like this. Yahan pe jaake, teen dots mein, the first option is Seller Learning Center. Over here, you'll be able to go ahead and register yourself for tomorrow's webinar and learn more about the things that we have discussed over here under payment section. So thank you all for your time. Have a lovely day ahead. Thank you for joining. Take care. Happy selling.